What's going on, guys? I'm Zach from the Lumios Post, where we talk about all things Pokemon, and today we are talking about a giant leak that has kind of been confirmed, or at least given a lot of credit. I firmly believe it, so let's just dive right in. Before we do dive in, though, I am going to issue an obvious spoiler warning. These are leaks. This is not officially released information by the Pokemon Company, so I'd get out of here if you don't want to hear that. There is a little bit of plot stuff in here. I usually don't like plot leaks, but this is relatively small. And there is some stuff on the gimmick, the legendary typings, and the starters' final typings, as well as some regional form stuff. So without further ado, I'm going to give you a few seconds, and then we're going to dive in. All right, let's get into it. So this is a Google document that had kind of been passed around. The first person who I saw bring it up was Will-O-Wisp on Twitter, and they said that they were not the ones who made this. It was someone in the PoriLeaks Discord, and they found it through there. So, you know, I'd love to credit whoever did this. I'm not exactly sure who did this, though. If you reach out to me and want credit, you know, I'll put you in the description gladly. But anyways, this guy is talking about how there is a Chinese form called Baidu, and there was a leak going around like wildfire over there, and it didn't make its way into the West until this post. But it's from a guy that they're calling the uncle, and they're saying that the uncle was the one who stated before even Ku that there is a new Kami based off of Gimbu. The Kami trio is obviously Landorus, Tornadus, and Thundurus, and we did, in fact, get a new member of that Kami trio, or now quartet, called Enamorous, which was indeed inspired by Gimbu. Now, I don't know if this guy really did post this first. You know, I don't see the Chinese forms. I couldn't understand them if I did, but we're going to keep going with it. So, the claims, this guy states that Scarlet and Violet will be pulling heavily from old and scrapped ideas. The game concept has been gestating for a while, in contrast to what the 2022 release date would lead you to believe. So it seems like they've been bringing back some old scrapped ideas. I don't know if that's just ideas for the game or if that would also include Pokemon. The new gimmick is described as similar to job changing from Final Fantasy, but with types. We know from a lot of Ku's riddles that it seems to be a third type. The gimmick seems to be a Pokemon being able to grab an additional type in battle, allowing for dual type Pokemon, at least like Charizard, to grab a third type. They said that the storyline has vague similarities to BW Black and White, which involves two feuding families who rule the region, with one of the two, and they said that this is conjecture on their part as they were compared to Charon and Bianca, rivals will get the opposite mascot legend. And all of this does tie into some stuff that Ku has stated, and we're going to go over that at the end, but we're going to keep going right now. So, new Pokemon informs. This is really the huge, huge, huge thing. Scarlet and Violet will have one of the largest new Pokemon selections in a very long time, around the ballparks of Gens 1, 3, and 5. So that's absolutely crazy. That means, to give you an idea, Gen 1 had 151 Pokemon. Gen 5 had, if I'm not mistaken, 155. It may have been 156, but I think it was 156 new Pokemon. And then Gen 3 had 135 in it. So the amount of new Pokemon being around there is absolutely crazy. To be honest, this may include regional variants in that number, but even if that's the case, that's still really good, because regional variants have usually only been in the teens. In Sun and Moon, they were only in the teens. In Sword and Shield, before the DLC, they were in the teens, and same for Legends Arceus. They never go into the 20s. So even if, let's say, 19 of those are regional variants, that's still well over 100 new Pokemon, so that's absolutely crazy. So then, now going into the starters. The starters' final typings are Grass Dark, Fire Ghost, and Water Fighting. It's essentially the Pokemon Legends Arceus types, but with Grass and Water Switch, because Pokemon Legends Arceus Samurott was water, dark. Typhlosion was fire, ghost. And then Decidueye became grass, fighting. Now, I think this is really cool, and I could certainly see that. Sprigatito has been described to have some capriciousness and be very attention-seeking, and I could see that becoming dark type when it's older. Fuecoco has a lot of elements of ghost in it. It seems to have a skull. It is possibly inspired by the ghost pepper. So fire ghost makes a ton of sense. And also its name may also be derived from El Coco, which is like the Iberian boogeyman. And then Quaxly becoming water fighting, I can also really see, as it seems to be inspired by a sailor or a navy man of some kind. Then the mascot legendaries are Dragon Fighting and Dragon Electric. So that's pretty crazy, because Dragon Electric has already been done for a mascot typing with Zekrom back in Black and White. So this would be the first time they repeat the mascot legendaries typing, with the only other kind of time being Necrozma was pure psychic, and of course Mewtwo was pure psychic. But I don't think that really counts, because Mewtwo wasn't even the box legendary. The games were red, blue, or red and green, you know, clearly inspired by the starters, not the legendary. So moving into regional variants, in addition to the brand new Pokemon Surge, regional forms will also still be sticking around. That's awesome, you know, love that. Then they say that one of them will supposedly be based on Ratoncito Perez, which is the Spanish mouse version of the Tooth Fairy. Then the person who wrote this document says that they didn't indicate what Pokemon this is, what Pokemon is getting this form, but they're assuming it is Dedenne, because Ratoncito Perez is effectively a Spanish version of the French Tooth Fairy Mouse, which is what Dedenne is based off of. That's actually why it's part fairy type. Then the other claim form is for, surprise, surprise, Tauros, supposedly fighting type and Minotaur based. Unclear if it's a regional or a straight up cross gen Evo, which is worthwhile consideration in a post-Ursaluna world. To top this off, the leaker claimed that further hints lie within PLA, although no explanation was given as to what these hints are or what they allude to. So there are more hints in Pokemon Legends Arceus. We don't know what they are yet, but I'm sure it'll become very as evident as we start to get more information on Scarlet Violet, and certainly when the games are out. So I will talk about the Ratoncito Perez thing for a second. I actually think that this will be a Patrat variant. The reason I think this is because yesterday we actually had Ku post some riddles, and I'll put a link in the description to my video on that, but because we did cover that yesterday. But he did hint that at a clearly a Tauros variant, especially when you cross check it with this, it was a Tauros variant. And then he also posted about another variant, and he put 3?, 4?, 5?, 2? Basically asking, you know, what gym will the other one be? And given that it's likely these two are getting their information from the same source, because they're both revealing two variants, they're both revealing the legendary typings and the gimmick, they very well could be getting their information from a same or similar source, whether it's like from an investor's meeting or something. But I think that the most fitting Pokemon from either Gen 2, 3, or 4, or 5 would be Patrat for this. We always get a regional rodent variant anyways, so it just makes sense to me. But that is, of course, speculation on my part. So to look at why this thing could be very real, yesterday, like I said, we had Ku drop a bunch of hints, and he revealed that in March, he had posted this master's image, and a lot of people thought that it was hitting at the starter typings, assuming that it was water fighting Quaxly, fire dragon Fuecoco, and grass electric Sprigatito. But he revealed yesterday that the theme of, I said it was March, but April, sorry, was actually on legendaries. So instead, that seems to imply that those gears are actually the legendaries typings, dragon fighting, dragon electric, which does line up with this. Ku also, again, like I said, he's hinting at these two forms, which very well could be the same forms that the Chinese uncle is hinting at. He also put in the master's picture a picture of N with Zekrom. Now, the thing that's very interesting about that is it could have been a hint in itself, as N is your rival in Black and White, and he gets the opposite mascot legendary, and the uncle revealed that your one of your rivals in this game will get the opposite mascot legendary, so it does seem like that was a hint at that as well. Also, Ku mentioned that there were a lot of cool new Pokemon designs and creative designs, and just him kind of saying a lot, it makes me feel like he's hinting at, hey, there's a lot of new Pokemon in this game. It definitely seems to be the case that that's what he's saying. So, very likely that this is legit, and that, you know, that lines up with this, with it being one of the largest selections of Pokemon that we've had since Gen 5. Also, for what it's worth, Ku had posted a teaser to his Master's Riddle that showed Decidueye, Samurott, and Typhlosion. Now, he was trying to hint at how to figure out his other riddle. And so he kind of had this one set up where you see Decidueye, Typhlosion, Samurott, and they're obviously their regular forms. But if you look at the gears at the top, you see that they are for fighting, they are for dark, and they are for ghosts. But the order that they're in are dark, ghost, fighting. Now, that's not the typings of the Hisuian starters. Decidueye wasn't grass ghost, Typhlosion was fire ghost, and Samurott was not water fighting. But if you were to replace these starters with the starters for Scarlet and Violet, it actually would line up correctly. So if you replace Decidueye with the grass starter for Scarlet and Violet, Sprigatito, grass dark does work. If you replace Typhlosion with the fire starter, Fuecoco, fire ghost still works if you line it up with the Uncle Leek. And then Samurott, replace it with Quaxly, water fighting, again, what the Uncle Leek is saying. So, Ku kind of snuck in a little hint in this, what he said was a practice round for his other post. But I think that's really interesting, and I think there's definitely a lot of evidence to say that this Uncle Leek is real. I'm fully putting all my stake into it. And guys, I gotta say, having over 100 new Pokemon, that sounds like a dream come true. And it's something that, in a world with regional variants and gimmick forms like Megas and Dynamax, or Gigantamax, excuse me, I didn't think that this would ever happen. So this is super exciting, and I don't know, just let me know your thoughts on this in the comments below. Do you believe the Uncle Leek? Do you not? You know, I do, but let me know your thoughts on it, and let me know how psyched you are for these games after hearing this stuff if you do indeed believe this. Be sure to like, subscribe, and hit the bell for notifications. We cover all things Pokemon here. That'll be official Scarlet and Violet news. That'll be speculation on it. And that will be leaks like these. Until next time, I will see all of you later.